Today we will talk about bubble sort algorithm. In bubble sort algorithm, we start with the first item in the list and then we'll compare it with the immediate item towards its right. And if the item is greater on the left hand side, then we'll do a swap. And we will continue to do this comparison till the very end of the list, and we have to do multiple comparisons and of course multiple iterations until the list is sorted or until we have covered all the items in the list. And to understand this particular bubble sort algorithm, we need to take one example. So let us say we are trying to sort some numbers like 8, 5, 2, 1, 3 and 6. So let us say we have this number, and it's a very good example because in this particular list we have the biggest item, which is 8, at the very first position. So let us see how many iterations we need to do and let us see how many comparisons we need to do per iteration. So let us start with this particular list, and when we start the iteration, we have to start with the first position, which is at this position, and we have to compare it with the next item in the list, which is 5. So if we do a comparison of 5 and 8, of course we can see here that we need to swap them. So the next item will become, or the next list will become 5, 8, 2, 1, 3 and 6. And then we have to compare it with 2, and again we have to do a swap. So the list will become 5, 2, 8, 1, 3, 6. Then we'll compare it with 1. The list will become 5, 2, 1, 8, 3, 6. Then we'll compare 8 with 3. The list will become 5, 2, 1, 3, 8, and 6. And finally, we'll do a comparison of 8 and 6, and the list will become 5, 2, 1, 3, 6, 8. And if you notice, in this particular list, the number 8 has now reached its final position, which is the last position. And we have done 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 comparisons. So if we have to write here how many iterations we did, we of course have done so far one iteration, and in iteration number 1, we have done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 comparisons. So I'll probably write here for our understanding I1, iteration number 1, and C5, comparison number or number of comparisons 5. So let us now proceed further, and we have this new list here, and the next time we'll do a comparison of first item towards or with its item on the right hand side. We'll not worry about the last number because it is already at its final position. So in the next iteration, we'll have a shorter list with, you can say, n minus 1 items. So let us now proceed further and do a comparison of 5 with 2. The list will become 2, 5, 1, 3, 6, 8. Then we'll compare 5 with 1. The list will become 2, 1, 5, 3, 6, 8. Then we'll compare 5 with 3. The list will become 2, 1, 3, 5, 6, and 8. Then we'll compare 5 with 6. And you must be wondering that 5 is now less than 6, and there is no need to do any comparison, but we still need to do a comparison, and when we do a comparison, we can obviously figure out whether we need to do a swap or not. So in this particular case, there is no swap required, but the list is now sorted, or you can say the last two items in the list is now, or they are now sorted. So we were actually worried about the first, or we were actually doing this comparison for n minus 1 items in our second iteration. So by the end of second iteration, we have done 1, 2, 3, 4 comparisons, And if we write it down here, we have done 4 comparison after iteration 2, and the numbers 6 and 8 are now at their final position in the list. So let us now do third iteration. So when we do the third iteration, I'll probably write it here on the right hand side. So we have to start with the first item, which is 2, and we'll compare it with 1. So the list will become 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and 8. And then we'll compare 2 with 3, and the list will become 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and 8. Then we'll compare 3 with 5. And you must be wondering that why are we proceeding further, because 2 is less than 3. And you're right, we don't need to proceed further, but since we are talking about the iteration and the number of comparisons, we have no way to figure out, unless we do some optimization in the code, we still need to proceed further. And in this particular case, of course, there is no further comparison required after third iteration. So after third iteration, which started here, we have done 1, 2, 3 comparisons, and the iteration is 3. And let us now do the fourth iteration with this particular list. And of course, we have 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and 8. And by the way, after our iteration number 3, the numbers which are 5, 6, and 8, they are now at their final position. So when we talk about iteration number 4, we have to again do a comparison of 1 and 2, and then we have to do a comparison of 2 and 3. And there is no further further swap required, because the list is already sorted, and 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3. But after our fourth iteration, the list is now almost sorted. Of course, we know it is sorted, but when we are talking about the number of comparisons, we did 2 comparisons, and we are talking about iteration number 4. And we still need to do one more iteration, by the way, which is for the list with 2 items. So when we do a comparison of 1 and 2 in our fifth iteration, we will have, of course, no swap required. So the list will become 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8. And in this particular case, there is no swap required, and we have done all the iterations based on the number of items in the list. And if you talk about number of comparisons in this particular iteration, which is number 5, we have done just 1 comparison. So why I'm talking about the number of comparisons and number of iterations? I'm talking about this particular number because when we talk about the complexity of the algorithm, we need to understand how many times we are going into the loop. So in this particular case, we started with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We started with a list of 6 items in the list, and we have done so far, so let us write it down. We have the length of our list or array, or you can say n is equal to 6, which was the input. We did 5 iterations, so we ran our loop at least 5 times, and I'll probably write it down, iterations, we did 5, and within each iteration we also did some comparisons. So we did 5 comparisons in the beginning, then we did 4 comparisons, then we did 3 comparisons, then we did 2 comparisons, and so on. And by the way, whenever we are talking about the comparisons, we are talking about one more loop which is running within our outer loop of number of iterations, which is of course n minus 1. And we talk about these comparisons because the time complexity for this particular algorithm, which is bubble sort, is n square, because we are talking about the worst case scenario when the list is of course not sorted at all, and we are talking about a huge set of items, very large input. So the time complexity is O n square if we talk about the big O notation. And just to talk about whether this algorithm is useful or not, bubble sort is useful or not, well, for a very small list of numbers, the bubble sort will probably work fine. But when we talk about a big list, like let us say thousands or maybe millions of numbers, forget about using bubble sort, because it will take a lot of time. And it is very clear, because based on the iterations and the comparisons we did, we were able to figure out that the time complexity is O n square. So I hope this video was useful. Thank you very much.